We're mentioning the government shutdown now on day 10. As you can see, though, the market up today. And we've talked a little bit in the past, actually, about how the market hasn't really taken much of a hit. But maybe we'll talk today about why it's up. Bob Fazio, financial advisor with Morgan Stanley, here now to talk with us more about this. And, Bob, you know, we haven't seen a huge drop-off, but today we're seeing a surge. What do you think's causing it?
Well, the news today, and it was good news. It's good news no matter what side of the political aisle you're on, of the Republicans talking about a possible deal created this debt limit ceiling. Of the two events, the government shutdown and the debt limit deadline, if you will, it's the debt limit deadline that is the most troublesome. That's the one where there's not a lot of room to wiggle. That good news, the talk about a possible deal coming between the president and some of the Republicans creating a short-term agreement has caused the market to rally.
And am I right there in that we haven't seen a huge drop-off with the 10 days of the shutdown that we've been experiencing?
You're right, Jerry. There really hasn't been much of a drop-off. I mean, it's not that we haven't been through this before. There have actually been 12 government shutdowns in the last 33 years, some lasting 3 days, some 5 days, the longest being 21 days back in 1995. Now, really, most of us haven't remembered that. And all of them, of course, come to some resolution. This one, of course, there hasn't been real panic about it. So the sides haven't been really quick to say, we've got to come to some agreement. Pressure is building on both sides to come into agreement, and there's no doubt that they have to.
Yeah, I guess there's also something to be said about Americans maybe getting used to this sort of thing, perhaps. But you know, also worth noting, President Obama has selected Janet Yellen to lead U.S. Central Bank. Any impact from that, you think, on the market?
Janet Yellen is the current Fed vice chair. When Larry Summers removed his candidacy several weeks back, and he was really the market's choice and the choice of a lot of people, and in the minds of most of us, President Obama's first choice. But Janet Yellen is the vice chair. She is highly regarded. They respect her ability to reason. She would be the first woman chair of the Fed, and it would be very difficult not to nominate her, which he has done. Now, there's a question of whether she'll pass through the nominating process. The odds are 60% to 70% that she will. With respect to policy and the Fed, it's probably looking like more of the same, which the markets actually like. She'll keep rates relatively low, in fact, so low that they want to encourage borrowing for automobiles and mortgages, just as has happened in the last 4 or 5 years. In a nutshell, it's going to be more of the same, a very easy money policy, should she get confirmed.
All right. Well, we'll keep an eye on that. I know you will, too. Bob Fazio, thank you for joining us.